Hello students, good morning. We have already started a topic, differentiations. We have already done basic rules for differentiation. We have done its product rule and quotient rule also. We have also done the implicit functions. In our previous lecture, we have done the logarithmic differentiation. In continuation of that topic, today we will discuss the parametric functions. Before discussion of parametric function, let's discuss that what is the parametric equations. Parametric equation, it is a set of equations that defines that coordinate of dependent variable. It may be in x variable, it may be in y variable. Of curve, equation may be of curve, equation may be of a surface of a line. In term of one or more independent variable. Independent variable is called the parameter. Now, if I am saying that x is equal to 2t, y is equal to 4t, z is equal to 60. X, y and z, these all are the dependent variable and its all values are depend upon the value of t. That means t is the parameter and x, y, z are the dependent variable. Which value depend upon the t variable. Now, in case of functions there, if x and y are two functions in single variable t, same with the parametric equation. Now, I am taking x and y are if two functions with the single variable t, how will we write it? Y is equal to function of t and x is equal to g function of t. Then, x and y are called the parametric function because these two values having the same variable, that variable is t there. And t is called its parameter through which we will find out the change in these two functions. Now, what is the working rule? Simple rule. As we know the differentiation, the parametric function is very easy to solve it. Its first rule is we will write the form in the function. Y is equal to ft, x is equal to gt. Then we will find out whatever the common variable is there, differentiation with respect to that variable. Now I am taking t is the common variable there. Therefore, it will be become dy upon dt. Same case, dx upon dt with respect to t. Now to find the value of dy upon dx. Now I have to find out the value of dy upon dx. Dy upon dx means its value is of the numerator. And we will divide it value with the dx upon dt. Dy upon dt divided by dx upon dt. When divide will change into multiply, this value will be in the reciprocal form. And we will get the value of dy upon dx. Now I am taking one or two examples for more understanding of this topic. Now, if I am taking that x is equal to 280 square and y is equal to 84. And I have to find out the value of dy upon dx. Now according to first working rule, I will write down it is in the function form. X is equal to this statement, y is equal to a t raised to power 4. Now t is the common variable, we will differentiate both sides with respect to t there. Now it will become dx upon dt, it will become dy upon dt. Now 2a is the constant term, according to differentiation rule, 2a will become forward. And we will differentiate with respect to t of t square. Same way a forward d dt of t raised to power 4. According to rule of differentiation, t square means power will come forward. T 2 minus 1 t is there. 4 t raised to power 4, 4 t cube. Now, its value is 4 a t cube. Its value is 4 a t. Now, we have to find out the value of dy upon dx. For dy upon dx, dy upon dt value numerator divided by dx upon dt. Now dy upon dt value is 4 a t cube, divide change into multiply and reciprocal of the term dx upon dt, 1 upon 4 a t. Whatever terms are to be cancelled, we will cancel that term and the answer is t square. Now I am taking one more example for the more understanding. I am taking here the t ratio example. I have to find out the value of dy upon dx and the x is b cube sin square theta, y is a cube cos square theta. According to first rule, I will write down the statement in the function form. Now, which is the common variable here? Theta is there. We will differentiate with respect to theta to both sides there. Dx upon d theta. Now, b cube will be come forward and theta is there. We will differentiate sin square theta. Same way, cos square theta, d dx of cos square theta. Now, if we differentiate sin square theta, first is the term of degree there. 2 will come forward, sin theta. 2 minus 1, 1 sin theta is there. Now, it's term of the sin theta. Same case, 2 cos theta, dd theta of cos theta. A cube is there. 2 cos theta differentiation is minus sin theta differentiation is cos theta. Now, this is the formula of sin 2 theta. We have already done in trigonometry in plus 1. This is again the formula of sin 2 theta. Now, b cube sin 2 theta minus a cube sin 2 theta. Now, to find out the value of dy upon dx, dy upon d theta numerator divided by dx upon d theta. Now, dx upon d theta we will take in the reciprocal form by converted into multiplication sign. A cube sin 2 theta multiply 1 upon b cube sin 2 theta. Now, sin 2 theta is cancelled with sin 2 theta and answer is minus of a cube upon b cube. Now, I am taking one more example, beta, where the functions are in the quotient rule, where we will apply the quotient rule. Now, dy upon dx is there. X is there. 1 plus log t upon t square. Y is equal to 3 plus 2 log t upon t. Now, which common variable is there? T. That means we have to differentiate with respect to t. Now, I am taking first equation. X is as it is there. Second function upon first function according to quotient rule. Dx upon dt. T square whole square. Now, whenever we differentiate 1 plus log t, 1 differentiation is 0, log t differentiation is 1 upon t. 1 plus log t as it is, t square differentiation is 2t there. Now, t square square of t square is t4. T if t cancel, t is there, minus 2t upon this one divided by t4. Now, as we solve, y is equal to 3 plus 2 log t upon t, so it will become dy upon dt. Answer will be minus 1 minus 2 log t upon t square. You will solve with the full quotient rule differentiation. I have written only the answer here. Dy upon dt minus 1 minus 2 log t upon t square. Now, whenever you find out the value of dy upon dx, you will write down this term as the numerator written and whatever term is there, it will be the denominator. Now, you can take t as a common number here. 1 minus 2 minus 2 log t by applying arrow method. Now, by cancelling the term, y minus 1 minus 2 log t, whenever you solve it, it will also equal to minus 1 minus 2 log t. Full bracket is cancelled with this term and t square will cancel with this term. 1 t is also cancelled and answer is t there. Now, students, I hope you will do related questions of this exercise also. Your exercise 11.4 is totally related to this topic. You will get one link related to this topic. You will also get module, RoboMet module link related to this topic. Go through that links also. Do more practice. I hope you will do. Thank you.